Another thing that I like is that during our spring season, the soccer, like our coach, allows us to practice just 2-3 times a week, so we can balance at the same time sport and study, and it is something that, for example, in Italy you can do. You cannot do, and this is the reason why a lot of athletes quit their sport, because you cannot do both things at the same time.
I think the thing that I like most about playing on the soccer team in Shorter is just like my teammates and having like a family that I can rely on. All the student athletes in the community, like the friendly environment, the role, the friendly.
What I like about shorter to play here in Shorty is like I can mix my studies and my favorite sport, like tennis. What I like about the shorter athletics is like we have a lot of sports, so we can meet a lot of people from different sports, so I love that.
I think we need indoor tennis courts and local rooms for girls and boys for the tennis team.
What I think we need to improve in the tennis department is like we need the indoor facilities because sometimes it gets really cold here and sometimes rain and snow, and I think we need that.
Hey everyone, we have the chance today to have an exclusive interview of Philipp Mittelkamp coming directly from Germany, being a master's student in Shorter University and playing for the Shorter Ox men's soccer. So Philipp, how are you today?
Thank you, Jordan. Hello, America. Thank you to give me the chance that I can speak with you. I'm very good. I hope you are doing well too.
I'm doing good. Always. So first, I would like you to tell me about your experience. How do you like Shorter, the university, the school? Like, how is it to be like a master's student in America? Like, tell me a bit about it.
Oh, I'm really happy to be here. The thing is, last year in August, I got the big opportunity to come to America, and I got a scholarship here at Shorter University for playing soccer. And especially for us European guys, it's a big thing. It's a big chance to come to America and play here soccer on a high level. And I think for us it's every day we can learn something. And what I really like here at Shorter is it's maybe not the biggest school, it's small, but we know each other. So we know all the European students, we know the American students. They are really open-minded, always friendly, and I like it. It's more like a family. You know everyone, and that is what I really appreciate here.
Oh, okay. Really nice. And soccer-wise, how did the season go with the coach? How was everything like? I'm curious about it because I followed your results, but I just wanted to like hear your personal opinion because I know that the coach left at the end of the year, like without really like telling the team, ahead, and then maybe it causes trouble for the spring or something. Tell me about it.
Yeah, John, you're completely right. So we had a pretty good season. The last season was, I would say, maybe the best season for Shorter soccer in the last 20 years. And our team had a great success. The only problem was at the end of the season, Coach Ben said, "Hey guys, I have to tell you something. Because of some problems, I have to leave the team. I'm searching for a new... for something new in my life, and I go back to my hometown." And I mean, it's a shock for everyone if the coach says after a really successful season, "I have to leave the team and you have to find a new coach." Yeah, it was tough. This time was really tough for us. And right now, to be honest, it's maybe not the best situation here because we don't have a coach anymore. We have Fernando de Barros. He's a graduate student as well, and he's doing an absolutely great job. He's trying everything to help us guys out. We have practice nearly every day, but I mean, it's not the same if you have not a real coach. And the problem is right now that Fernando cannot recruit anyone. And I think the problem is if we want to have success next season, we need new players, especially some players from Europe. And the problem is that Fernando cannot recruit them. He's not allowed to do that. And I really hope that in the next days or the next couple of weeks, we will find a new coach.
Okay. So tell me, what are the main difference between what we call soccer here and football in the Division 2 level that you have the chance to play in? What is the main difference that like shocked you at the beginning? What was the like characteristic of soccer that like made you think like, whoa, like I'm not in my country anymore, like I'm not in my continent, like, you know?
Yeah, I think that's a really great question, because compared to Europe, it's a complete different soccer or football, because in Europe we play more tactical, we play not so physical, and I have the feeling that here it's all about running, conditioning. You have to be as fit as possible, because I mean the season is tough and it's running so fast. So basically you have a game on Monday, you have a game on Friday, Sunday. So sometimes you play three times a week, and then your body has to recover, and it's really difficult to hold this level over the complete season. A lot of guys were injured last season, and it was a problem for us. And I think this is the biggest difference between Europe and America. In Europe we have more time to recover our body, and also to combine the university, to learn in the night and then wake up at mornings at 6 a.m. in the morning and go to practice. Sometimes it's really hard. That's the biggest difference. But to be honest, I like the competition here.
You like the competition?
Yeah, I like the competition.
And how were the team in the conference? Were they good, or you expected like a better level from them, or?
To be honest, I expected that the level is a little bit higher. Mm-hmm. But at the end, when we go to the final tournaments, the level was really high. There were some guys who played really good soccer, some guys from America, some guys from Europe. You could see that these guys have a lot of experience in soccer, and yeah, I think for us it was a great, really great opportunity to play in Tennessee, and we learned a lot of that.
And you, the oldest person in the team, I mean,
yeah, that's right,
45 years old.
Yeah,
I was wondering how do you see the players in the team? Like, do they act like? Is the team mature? Is the team is the team first acting like a team? Tell us about the locker room. How is the locker room?
Yeah, that's something interesting, because when I look back to my home team in Europe and Germany, I have the feeling it's more a team, because, for example, when we meet after a game, we sit together, we eat something together, we eat a pizza, some fries with chicken, and we hang out together, and